Hello and welcome to What is DHCP, a dynamic host configuration protocol presented by Sailesh Mehta. And those are my credentials. That's the email in case you wish to contact me. And that's the website that you can go to look more information up. So I'm going to show you a TechNet article. This is on the Microsoft.com website. And the reason why we're here is to show you the Microsoft definition of DHCP, or Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Is an Internet Engineering Task Force, IETF standard, designed to reduce the administrative burden and complexity of configuring hosts on a TCP/IP, which is Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol-based network, such as a private network, which all of us have either in the office or at home. So the objective is that whenever we want to automate the process of assigning IP addresses to our computers, whether they be clients, whether they be servers, whether they be laptops, desktops, even mobiles, devices like smartphones, tablets, all of these devices need to have an IP address. So then the question becomes, how do we configure a DHCP server? What are the steps? So first of all, DHCP is a server role. So means you need to have Windows Server installed. Once you have Windows Server installed, you go to the server manager, you go to the local server, you go to the manage tab, and you click on add roles and features. When the wizard comes up, go next. We're going to do a role-based or feature-based installation, so go next. We're going to select the local server, go next. And there it is, DHCP. So the minute I clicked on DHCP, which is Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol Server, enables you to centrally configure, manage, and provide IP addresses and other information to client computers. It wants us to add these features. So click on Add, because otherwise DHCP will not be installed. Now we are ready. Go next. We are not adding any of the features. Just go next. Here is another brief summary of what DHCP is and why we need it. Things to note, you should configure at least one static IP address on this server. And before you install DHCP server, you should plan your subnet scopes and exclusions and store the plan in a safe place for later reference. So we're going to go next to complete the installation. Here is an option to restart the server automatically if required. I don't think so, so I'll just go install. Now we have to wait for the installation to complete. And as you can see, the DHCP server installation has completed. Now we need to verify that the installation was correctly done. So click close. We don't need server manager. By the way, in server manager, the first verification is right here. Say, DHCP now admin tool is available, confirms that DHCP is installed on the server. It shows you the server name, the IP address, and whether this DHCP server is online, when was it last updated, and the Windows is activated. Now it's also telling you that you need to configure DHCP to issue IP addresses. So that's what we'll be doing next. So I'm going to close this. I'll go to my MMC, and I'm going to add the DHCP admin tool to my MMC. There it is. So I'm going to go to File, Add, Remove, Snap In. Click on DHCP, Add. Click OK. And make sure you save it for future reference. So there is DHCP. Now, one of the first things you got to do is be sure that the DHCP server must be authorized. By by default, the DHCP server is not authorized. Only Active Directory enterprise administrators can authorize a DHCP server. So I'm logged in as an enterprise admin, so I can authorize this DHCP server, which I'm doing right now. If you don't, notice there are red downward pointing arrows on the IPv4, IPv6. Reason is the DHCP server is not authorized. The minute the authorization completes, then everything will turn green. And if you right click the server, instead of authorized, now it will say unauthorized. Means it's already authorized. Okay. Now, see, everything turned green. So green means the DHCP server is authorized. Red means it's not authorized. Now, I can define a scope either in IPv4 or IPv6. So a scope is a range of IP addresses that can be assigned to computers requesting a dynamic IP address. In order to do that, you must create and configure a scope before the IP addresses can be assigned. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to create a IPv4 scope. And after you create the scope, I'm going to show you how to assign the scope options. In this presentation, I'm going to discuss about the server. So in the server, one of the first things you have to do, by the way, we have verified that DHCP is installed on this server. Now, if I go to server options are additional configuration parameters that a DHCP server can assign to DHCP clients. For example, you can assign the IP address for your default gateway or routers, your WIN servers, your DNS servers, to all the clients that ask or take an IP address from this DHCP server. So to define service options, you right click and you select configure options. I'm just going to show you the common ones that are very popular. So first is notice that the server options are different for IPv4 and IPv6. Under IPv4, you have options beginning with 2, which is time offset, and the router. To assign the router IP address, you've got to select it. Then you can assign a name if you have one, or you can just add the IP address. In order to define the gateway, you can do an IP config all, which is what I've done, to find out the default gateway for the server, which happens to be 192.168.0.1. So that's what I'm going to type over here, 192.168.0.1. So this is how you assign server options. And they're different for IPv4 and IPv6. The other common options that you define are the DNS server, and either you can assign the name or, and I'm going to make it the same box because this is a DNS server, so notice we have configured two options, the router address and the DNS server. The next two we are going to define are .15, which is the domain name. In this case, happens to be acesinc.local. And the last two to round up are for the WIN server, in case you have it. Say number 44, which is the Win server. So in case you have a Win server, you can assign the Win server. And then you have the Win's node type. And there are four node types, and we'll discuss this in a future video. But the options are 0 by 1, 0 by 2, 0 by 4, and 0 by 8. And I've selected 0 by 8. So that's it. We have defined all the common options: router, DNS server, DNS domain name, Win server, and the node type. In the next videos, we will discuss more about DHCP scopes and how to use the DHCP server to assign IP addresses to the clients. I hope you enjoyed this and look forward to seeing you back in the next videos. Thank you for listening.